Hello everyone, today we will discuss about the API score, that is Academic Performance Index score, that is used for recruitment of assistant professor in various universities and colleges. So as you know that for the recruitment of assistant professor vacancies in universities and colleges, there is a API score being used for the shortlisting of candidates for the interview purpose. The API score regulations were introduced by UGC in the year 2018. And before that, there were also various regulations, but in 2018, a major change was introduced. So in this video, we will discuss about what changes are introduced, what are the regulations, and what are the amendments that were made by the UGC. So let's begin our discussion. For more informative videos, you can subscribe to our channel. And if you are preparing for UGC NET management exam for December 2019 attempt, you can join our course pack. The website is given in the description below. And if you want to attempt quizzes for commerce and management, you can join our Telegram group, which is also given in our description. So let's begin our discussion. So before we begin, I will tell you how to visit UGC website and search for the UGC new regulations for each and every subject matter, that is either MPhil PhD admission, that is either for recruitment of assistant professor vacancies, and any other information that are being released by the University Grant Commission. So let's begin. So first, what you have to do is to visit UGC website, you can search UGC regulations. So when you search for UGC regulation, you will get this one. The second one, UGC regulation, click on it, and here you will get various information regarding notification on specification of degrees. So various degrees, how they are governed, about the maintenance of institutions, about the grant of degrees, about the information about universities. Actually, every university has to file a return about their expenditure, income, and many other things. So that is to be filed with UGC, and all these information are also available here. Now, in point number 5th, you see that there is a minimum qualification required to be appointed as teacher, staff, and other post. So in this, you will find all the information regarding the appointment of assistant professor, associate professor, and professor post, and also librarian post and other academic staff. So here you will see that in point number 5, sub point 6, there is UGC regulation on minimum qualification for appointment of teacher and other academic staff in universities and colleges, and measure the maintenance of standards in higher education 2018. Actually, these standards and regulations were released by the UGC in July 2018 and applicable on university from that day. Some of the provisions are applicable from 2021, which we will see in this. So if you click on the 6th point, you will get a PDF. So let's see the PDF, how it is. So this is the PDF. First 56 pages are of Hindi version, and later on from page number 57, you will get the English version of that regulation. So let's see what are the regulations are. So in this regulations, we will see the major points which are covered for the recruitment purpose. So there is clause 1, that is, it will be called the minimum qualification regulation 2018. And second, this will be applicable to all the universities, whether they are central university, whether they are state university, or whether they are deemed to be universities. It will be applicable on all the universities. Now, UGC regulation on minimum qualification for appointment of teachers and other academic staff in universities and colleges, and other major for the maintenance of higher standards in higher education. So basically, these regulations are for the improvement of higher education system and maintenance of standard in higher education system. So next point tells about the coverage of it. So we will skip that point. You can read it in depth after downloading it. We will cover only the major points. So second, recruitment and qualification point. In this point, about the recruitment purpose, what are the qualifications required and what are the experience required is given. So clause number 1 says the direct recruitment for the post of assistant professor, associate professor, and professor in universities and colleges shall be based on the merit. So basically, what are the changes are, actually the recruitment will be done on the basis of merit basis. So merit basis is what is your qualification, what are your marks, what is your percentage of marks actually. So all these are counted in the merit. Now clause 3.2 says that the minimum qualification will also be applicable on the librarian, assistant director, physical education teacher and all other. Now, clause number 3.3 said that the national eligibility test NET or state level eligibility test SET or SLET shall remain the minimum eligibility for appointment of assistant professor. Basically, NET will be the minimum qualification or equivalent position where provided in the regulation. Further, SLET SET shall be provided as the minimum eligibility for the direct recruitment to universities, colleges and institutions in the respective state only. So basically, if you qualify NET, then your eligibility will be applicable all over the India. But if you have qualified state, that is state level eligibility test or SLET, then your eligibility for the appointment of assistant professor in the respective state only where you have cleared the SET or SLET exam. Now, NET or SLET exam is exempted for the candidates who have PhD. So basically, if we talk about the PhD, there are some conditions also for the candidates who are PhD degree holders. So what are the conditions? Let's see. The PhD degree shall be awarded in the regular mode only. So if you have acquired PhD degree from open university or open source, then it will not be counted in your academic qualification. So this is point number one. Now point number two says that the PhD thesis have been awarded by at least two external examiners. So when your PhD thesis is examined, there are external examiners comes from various other universities to examine your PhD thesis. So this clause says that your PhD thesis has been awarded by two external examiners. So basically they are must examined by the two external examiners. So that is the second point. Now if you talk about the third point, an open PhD viva voce for the candidates have been conducted. So if you have awarded PhD, then the viva voce for the same must be conducted. So that is the third point. Now fourth point says the candidate have published two research papers from his or PhD coursework, out of which at least one is in a referred journal. So referred journal list is also available on the UGC website. You can search UGC care where you will get the list of approved journals. Now clause number 5, that is clause E, says that the candidates have presented at least two papers based on his PhD work in conferences or seminars sponsored or funded by the UGC, ICSSR or CSIR. All these are regulatory bodies of universities. So till now we talked about what are the minimum qualification, where it will be applicable, and NET shall be the minimum qualification. Now let's talk about the minimum marks which you should have scored in your master's level for the eligibility criteria. So a minimum of 55% marks is required for the general category candidates, and a minimum of 50% marks should be for SC, ST and OBC candidates. Now other points are not relevant or not very much important, so we will talk about only the important points. The PhD degree shall be mandatory qualification for the direct recruitment of post of assistant professor in universities, mind here universities, with effect from 1st of July 2021. So after 1st of July 2021, PhD degree will be mandatory for appointment as assistant professor in universities, not colleges. We will talk about the what are the criteria for colleges in the later video. Eligibility for assistant professor. So eligibility criteria 1 says a master degree with 55% marks or 50% for reserve category candidates. Other than that, you must have NET, that is you must have qualified UGC NET, or if you are a PhD candidate, then NET or SET will be exempted from you. And all other are the conditions that I have already discussed with you. Later, NET SET shall not be required for the master program in which the UGC NET is not conducted. So if in some subject UGC NET is not conducted, then in that subject NET is not required. Now, these are the regulations which were introduced for the appointment of assistant professor. In this video, we will not be talking about the associate professor or professor post, because if you get selected in the assistant professor, then you will get to know what are the conditions for the promotion as associate professor and professor post. So only one thing I will discuss with you. As an assistant professor, if you got your PhD degree along with 8 years of teaching experience, then you will get promoted to associate professor. And further, if you get 10 years of teaching experience, then you will get promoted as professor post. Now comes to the API score, that is academic performance score introduced by the UGC in 2018. So let's talk about that. So if you came to page number 107 of the regulation, then here you will find the UGC regulation or API score index, how it will be calculated for the recruitment purpose or for the selection purpose. So here there are some criteria, how much you have scored in your graduation or post graduation, then what will be your API score and all. So let's discuss. So in your graduation, if you have scored 80% and above, then you will get 15 points. If in your post graduation, that is masters, if you have scored 80% and above, then you will get 25 points. If you have MPhil, in your MPhil your marks is 60% and above, then you will get 7 points. For PhD, if you have completed your PhD, then you will get 30 points. NET along with GRF, then you will get 7 points, or only NET, you will get 5 points. Now SET is state level eligibility test. If you have cleared that exam, then you will get 3 points. Research publication, 2 marks for each publication, maximum of 5 publication. If you have published more than 5 research papers, then it will not be counted in your academic performance index. Only 5 papers in the approved list of journals will be counted for the API score. So you will get 10 points for 5 papers, that is 2 marks for each paper. After that, teaching experience, 2 marks for each year. Basically, if you have 5 years of teaching experience, then you will get 10 marks, that is 2 marks for each year of teaching experience. But here is a condition that the teaching experience must be postdoctoral. That is, your teaching experience along with your PhD will not be counted for the academic performance index. Now, if you have received any award, that is national level or international level, then you will get 3 points. If you have received state level awards, then you will got 2 points. And all these marks are calculated to get your API score. Now, for the appointment of assistant professor in colleges. So we will talk about the API score, how it will be calculated in case of colleges. So here, if you have scored 80% above in your graduation, then you will got 21 points. If you have scored 80% and above in post graduation, then you will got 25 points. In your MPhil, if you have scored 60% and above, then you will get 7 points. Then, and for PhD, you will get 25 points. NET with DRF, then you will get 10 points. Only NET, you will get 8 points. And for SET, you will get only 5 points. Research publication are similar to that of universities, but here the research publication are limited to only 3 researches. So if you have published 3 researches, then you will got 6 points, that is 2 marks per point of publication. But if you have published more than 3 journals, then it will not be counted in your API score. Now the teaching experience is similar to that is of universities, that is 2 marks for each year of teaching experience, and national level or international level awards 3 points, and state level awards get 2 points. So what are the differences between the university's API score and college's API score, we will discuss. So let's take an example. So we will discuss about what will be your university API score and what will be your college's API score in case you have some level of marks. So let's say you have 80% and above marks in your undergraduate, then you will get, as per university, you will get 15 points, maximum of 15 points. Now for PG, you will get maximum of 25 points. And if you have NET along with GRF, then you will get 7 points. One research paper is your published, then you will get 2 points for each research paper, and 1 year teaching experience, then you will got 2 points. So your total API score will be 40 plus 47, 49 and 51. So your API score will be 51. Now, if you talk about the college's API score, then if you have 80% in your undergraduate, then you will got 21 points. If you have 80% and above in your PG, that is post graduation, then you will got 25 points. That is similar. Now NET along with GRF will get 10 points. Teaching one research paper, that is 2, similar for university and colleges. And 1 year teaching experience will also be similar. that is 2 marks. So we will get 25 plus 35, 37, 39, 40 and 60. So you can see that if you want to teach in colleges, then your undergraduate marks matters a lot, your net GRF matters a lot, and also for the PhD, there is more weightage in universities and less weightage in colleges. So you can see that there is a difference for selection procedure in universities and colleges. So this is all about the API score and how they are calculated. We have seen it with an example. So you can calculate your own API score according to this if you want to apply for assistant professor in colleges. And now let's talk about the Delhi University recruitment, which recently has came out with the assistant professor vacancies in various departments. So here the Delhi University has implemented the same rules and regulation which were introduced by the UGC in the year 2018. So let's discuss about that. So this is the shortlisting criteria for the Delhi University for appointment of assistant professor. So here the API score will be used for the shortlisting of candidate for the assistant professor post. Here you can see that the same criteria which were introduced by the UGC has been implemented by the Delhi University, because there are some conditions and penalties which will be imposed on universities if they don't follow the UGC regulations. So Delhi University has followed the same regulations. Now, what are the important points in the selection criteria? So here the API score will be used and will be arranged in the descending order. So if you have highest API score, then you will be placed on the topmost position, and if you have very low API score, then we will be in the decreasing order and the below the line. Now in case of tie of marks, that is in API score for two candidates are similar, then the marks at the master's level will be used. The candidates having higher marks in the master's will be given preference. Now Delhi University has called the interview for the candidates securing more than 75 marks in the API score. So let's say that if you have only these marks and you are getting 51 marks, then you will not be called for the interview. But if there are no suitable number of candidates above the 75% academic criteria, that is API score, then the API score will be lowered. Then there are some chances that is the candidates having less than 75 marks in API, they may get interview calls. Now the marks awarded shall be used for the processing or screening of application. Now here the point says that if you have scored any marks or any publication or any teaching experience after the application form, that will not be counted in your screening, because in screening only those points will be counted which you have filled in your application form, and no other points will be counted. Now the similar points which I have already discussed, that is the teaching experience along with your doctoral, then that teaching experience will not be counted in your API score. And in case of dispute, the screening committee decision will be final. So you can download these regulations and application from the websites. So we have discussed the API score and what are the vacancies, how they are filled, and what are the criteria for the selection. If you have liked this video, then you can subscribe to our channel for more informative videos. We regularly upload informative videos for the aspirants. And if you are appearing for UGC NET management exam for December 2019, then you can join our